Hello, everybody. Derpy, I'm back. Ant-Man, Ariana, Gone Away, Sigmund, Neliel, Caleb. How are we doing, people? Welcome. I got to sneak them in. Ariana. Who was it that said they were missing the live stream? Ariana. Yep, it was Ariana. I got to sneak one in right now. That's what we're going to do. I have a collector's edition tin here. Look at that thing. It came damaged. I hope this is not a sign of the cards inside. I hope they're not dinged up. Hey, Dylan, pound it. I absolutely should pull something great, Dylan. Hey, Jason, how's it going? Welcome. Let's tear this open, I mean. And I'm not going to lie. I'm a little worried now. The first hobby box I opened, the condition was amazing, everybody. Now, lately, all the blasters I've been opening, some of the fat packs, the cards are all dinged up, and I don't quite understand. Put that to the side. Everybody loves some good foam. We got the bonus magnets. Good shiza, good shiza. Is that lagging? What's going on here? Hey, DK, pound it, welcome. Hey, go do what you gotta do, man. Go do what you gotta do. People, I am just surveying the packs off screen, off camera, so to speak, because I don't want to pull a relic or a patch, whatever it is in Food Fight. I have no idea what they have in Food Fight this year, but wish me luck. I'm hoping for a printing plate, everybody. I've yet to pull a printing plate. Where do you find the collectors? Just go on eBay, Jason. There's some websites that have them, like Steel City Collectibles, maybe Toy Wiz. I'm not a fan of Toy Wiz, man. They jack up the prices like crazy. Speaking of jacking up, everybody, I'm gonna be that YouTuber you hate. Let's jack up the likes. Smell them packs before you crack them. Wait. I want to go back to a comment. Caleb, because of you, I bought a series 4 unopened pack and now I love GPK. Caleb, welcome. Welcome to the addiction. That's awesome to hear, Caleb. Hey, Hollis, pound it. I am, man. I was out of town. Just got back in town. Put this on your TV. Problem solved. Yes, let the little ones enjoy a grown man open some GPK, everybody. Hey, yo, GC, a.k.a. Avo, in the house, everybody. Okay, I'm going to tell you one thing. I just inventoried a bunch of Food Fight cards. It took me about 4 hours today. I have 5 complete sets. I have numerous duplicates. I've yet to go through the booger greens or the pee-pee yellows or the purple jellies or the blacks, whatever those are called, the bruised blacks. I have no idea. E-Dogs, welcome. Pound it. Thank you, Dylan. I appreciate that. Okay, here we go. Am I in focus? You know what? I need to focus. Focus up. Twin Keith. I just want to make sure the hit's not in the first pack, because then all of you are gonna leave. Okay, we're good. We're good. We could continue, everybody. Alright, Twin Keith, I love this card. Obviously, referencing Twinkies, but I always think of Twin Peaks when I see that card. All right, we got a black border Balut Luke. Put you to the side. I need to create some space. This is quite embarrassing. Chocolat chip, Tex-Mex, ice cream sundae, boiled Bonnie. Ariana says I just pulled up the live on my TV so I can watch while I clean my room. Hey, you're multitasking. That's how you got to do it, Ariana. Let the games begin. Hopefully these games are fun, Hunted. Avo, aka GC Laredo 207, says hi, everyone. I hope you get your hit. Thank you. Lots of missing hit. Why do you have to put that juju on us? Why do you have to put that evil on me, Ricky Bobby? Come on, man. Come on, man. I was going to say something. I lost my thought. Yes. I know Victor Moreno is streaming right now. And in fact, if some of you want to go watch him, go ahead. You won't hurt my feelings. I hate to do it to him. Like, go live while he's streaming. Because I know there's not too many GPK channels that stream. But hey, I gotta take advantage when I can to stream. Hey, what are the odds? I start with Balut Luke, and now I got the Black Border Bolut. I'll take it. I'll take it. Do I have any OS1? No, Jason, I do not have OS1. I think the cheapest you can find an OS1 pack is for like $300. Something around those lines. And the thing is, that's a lot of money to pay for just 5 cards. Basically 3 cards if you remove the wax stain and the gum stain cards. That's a lot of money. And you're not guaranteed the cards that you want. You know, you want the Atom Bomb, you want the Nasty Nick. One day I'll bite the bullet. Besides, you know, I'm looking at it more along the lines like, you know, $300-$500 for an OS1 pack. With that amount of money, you could buy numerous boxes. You have a lot more material, so to speak, more content. Since I do make videos now, I'm like a video guy now. All right, James, shut up. Keep talking. No. When you shut up, you don't keep talking. You show. All right, Albacore, third helping Theo, and I have about 30 third helping Theos. It's nuts. Toasted. I saw that comment, Hunted. I saw that comment, and I don't want to read it because it hurts. Hunted says, to think I used to get them for a quarter pack from the ice cream truck. Yeah, listen. Well, after watching the documentary, the 30 years of garbage, apparently they released OS1, I guess in the New York area first. It spread a little bit. Because in Florida, I remember seeing the OS2 packs as a kid. OS3 was my first exposure because that's when my mom started buying me cards. Yep, we love it. We love it, Hollis. Okay, Abo and Hollis are speaking lovely to each other. How long is the stream going to be, E-Dogs? As soon as I'm done with this collector's edition, I'm probably done. Because I want to go and watch King Kong versus Godzilla. I was going to do it last night, but I was driving for like 12 hours yesterday. I was dead tired. I just fell asleep when I got home. Today I edited a couple videos. When they go up, I don't know. We'll play it by ear. What state am I from? I'm from Florida, Jason. The puzzle frame on the back wall. You mean my... You talking about those puppies? Wait, can I point my finger correctly? My mugged Marcus and my U.S. Arnie? That's what you're talking about, Jason? King Kong better win, Derpy. Only because King Kong reminds me of one of my dogs. Team Kong all the way, absolutely. Joe Blow, everybody. This is a great looking card. Spicy Spencer. No, why so soon? Why so soon? Here we go, baby. We got my spirit artist, Brent Engstrom, autograph card of Trashy Trey. Is that the name? I will take it. But you know what? There's still a possibility of pulling a gold in this box, everybody. All right, let me put this sucker to the side. Good news, it's not dinged up, everybody. It is not dinged up. Oh my god, the bad quality cards have been following me around lately. The puzzles are from third series, Jason. Derpy. Nice. Good Shiza, Dylan. We're gonna pull a gold. I feel it. We're gonna pull a gold. Okay. Avo. We don't have to worry about not pulling a hit. We have a hit, everybody. Talking Kong brought the vibes. That's funny, Con. That's my second auto from Food Fight. And people? I do have another sketch card from Food Fight. I actually pulled the second card, Food Fight sketch card. I'll put it up on a video. DK, why are we ruining the plot? DK is a bright... I'm probably older than DK, so I'm going to say DK is a bright young lad. And a smart guy, so you don't have to, like, you know... do some of that deductive reasoning and spoil it for us. A Black Border Hydrate Tate. Chuck Steak. Donut Don. Heat Nut Allergy. How many more packs? Probably 18. E-Dog. Jessica T. How's it going? Welcome. Pound it. You like that Ottawa, Beck? I'll take it. Listen, I wanted a printing plate. I mean, beggars can't be choosers. Especially since apparently some people aren't getting hits in their collector's tins. You know, speaking of not getting hits on the tins, I did see a YouTube video and... oh my God, what's the name of the person? She sent like a form to Tops because she didn't get a hit in her Sapphire box, and they sent her a Sapphire hit, which begs the question. If Sapphire is only a limited number of prints, or prints, you can say prints, how do they have extra hits on standby? You know, I'm calling some BS on that one. But anyways, I mean, how do they know that you didn't even get the hit? That's what I was trying to get at. It was good, but I'm Team Godzilla. Okay, guys, stop talking about it. Stop talking about it, please, please. Jason? No, Caleb. 1 second. Well, thank you for the editing skills comment, Jason. I appreciate that. Speaking of the editing, Jason, I just go with what I know, man. So what you see is what you get. It's what's inside my mind, basically. I'm lagging on the comments. Speaking of Food Cheese Charlie, everybody, for those of you that did watch the video where I sacrificed Charlie, he did survive. He's in the background. He's right here. He made it. I couldn't go all the way. I only got to third base. I saved them. Yeah, it wasn't a full sacrifice, so we'll see what happens. Okay, DK, you're a little bit older than me, a little bit. I should do a Transformers and G.I. Joe style. I have included Transformers and G.I. Joe in my videos, Jason. Okay, let me catch up. Caleb, my favorite pool ever is actually... oh, I put him away. It's my Nasty Nick from Pat C. Pat Chimung. Gasboy, I think I said hi. Pound it. I think I said hi. Abek is still searching for his first auto. Hollis is suffering from old. Guys, I'm suffering from young. Like kitty young. Inside my heart, kitty young. It doesn't matter what my birth certificate says. My wife tells me I'm 7 years old. Thomas, welcome. How's it going, Thomas? Looks like an overdone slice of pizza. Hey, has anybody ever ate at Anthony's Coal? Is it? There's one right by my house. Anthony's Coal Fire Pizza. What's the name called? Now I forget. It's crazy. I remember stuff from 30 years ago. I can't remember stuff from down the block. This is a good one to have. A Black Border Gummy Gunther. This is probably the best card in the set, in my opinion. Connoisseur, Bad Food Brad, Inflamed Colin. Charlie looks nice. I agree, Ant-Man. Oh, Gas Boy. Yes, I've completed this set a few times over. Minimum 5. And after this break, I'll have 6. Do you guys want me to read all the names? I'm trying to speed it up a little bit. Let me know. I'll do it. I'll read names. I like reading names. Yeah, well, Hollis, you're 3 years older than me then. You are what I would call mature. Blake Pizza. Blaze Pizza. Chunkatarian John. Who's that person who comments on every video? I think his name is Junk Food John Adventures. Always commenting about Junk Food John. Spitting Spencer. Herschel Squirts. That's funny. Listen, I'll throw myself out there. I went to Georgia last week. I just got back yesterday. Me and my wife's family, we were on a hike. And we were hiking up to see one of the waterfalls. And I had to go to the bathroom. So I ran off to the side on one of the trails. And number one people. And I go to the bathroom. And my wife's watching me. I'm just like dancing around, blah, 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 having fun. So when I'm done, I scream out loud, "I think I sharted." And right as I said it in turn, there was a girl right next to my wife. You should have seen the look on her face. She was like in shock, disgusted. Like all in one. I was so embarrassed. Alright, anyways, okay. What am I talking about? Buttercream Maxine. Great card. You never hold a sneeze in. Listen, DK. The last time I pulled my back out, I was about to sneeze. And I went into a full-blown panic attack. I was sweating because I knew the moment that I sneezed, I was done for. Whew. When you throw your back out, no joke. What will you do when you get 500 subscribers? I will thank all of you. How I thank all of you? You have to pay attention or stay tuned. How rare are the C variants? I think C variants are pretty rare, Jason. I consider them short prints, me personally. I'm not an expert. I'm not a GPK expert. But let's just imagine that the golds in Chrome Series 3 were numbered out of 50. I think the C variants are less than that. There might be only 50 for each card. So golds, there's 100 for each card. I mean, well, because there's two characters. You picked it up. That's hilarious. Flaky friend. I have some crazy stories, everybody. I have some crazy stories. All right, let's keep going. Sick Vlad. Janet Planet. They made Janet Planet great again. Charred Chuck. Macaroni. A brew moment. Where are you from, Gas Boy? Because one of the shows my wife watches, it's Below Deck. And I remember watching a season with her, and the guy kept saying brew. Like, hey, brew. Hey, brew. And I didn't know what country he was from. Great card. Let's all go. Hallen Oates. Woody Blocks. Okay. A red border Dawson cookies. Let's take a look at the number. Number 54 out of 75. Followed by Chocolat Chip. And I have this guy purple, yellow, green, and now black. Will I rainbow him? Probably not. Nothing like a shark to break the ice, especially on a first date. Listen. I can't talk. We're here to watch GPK, not talking about shart stories, everybody. I've never sharted. Let me clarify. I've never sharted. What I did as a one-year-old baby, it's not on me. Okay? In my opinion, you are under... Thank you, Caleb. I appreciate that. Caleb, I'm going to go big for the 500. Thank you. I'm going to go big. In my opinion, 500 for a GPK, I'm essentially... Listen, I could... I like many a thing. I could edit videos about anything. I used to do that a lot. But lately, this past, since the pandemic, I've been focusing on GPK. So for all intents and purposes, I am a GPK channel right now. And in my opinion, 500 subs for a GPK channel is massive. Obviously, when you compare it to like a million sub channel, it's like a penny. A percent of a penny. But for GPK related stuff, 500 is pretty big. I don't think I'll get bigger than that, to be honest. I'd have to start opening baseball cards and stuff like that. Well, yeah, brew is bro, but... Okay, so you're not going to tell me where you're from, Gas Boy? Come on. I do have this set, E-Dogs. I have it a few times over. Do I collect other things? I don't really collect. I have Legos, like big Lego sets, and when they drop, you know, like the Voltron, I love space Legos because my dad loves space Legos when I was a kid. Like dinosaur Legos, like Lego sets I have. Do I go out and like actively search for them? Nah, but when I see something in the store, like I have the Nintendo Lego, something pretty cool, I'll get it. I was about to say, why is this card upside down? Play Paul. Drawing Jessica. Stick up Stanley. A black border Tex-Mex. Chewy Charles, great card. Logan Lobby. But like other hobbies, let's say other hobbies, Jason. Golf. Movies. Video games. I like playing Call of Duty, to be honest. Go big or go home. That's right. Instead of Shark Week, Discovery needs to have Shark Week. Thoughts? I mean, I would watch it because it would probably be hilarious. It'd be beyond hilarious. I remember being young in the bath and sharting. A shite submarine almost did a full lap around me in the bath. That's lovely, DK. That's lovely. Vanpack, welcome. Pounded. Thank you for showing up. Yeah, it was pricey. You know what I think would be pretty cool, hunted for like the Voltron Lego, because they have like obviously, you know, the five lions and the different colors, the blue, green, red, you know. To get the same pieces but kind of like black, gray, whatnot, and to make kind of like a metaled out Voltron, so to speak. GC has all the space Legos. You can see the Saturn V in my live feeds and space shuttles. Sweet, sweet GC. I'm a big fan of like late 70s, early 80s space sets from Lego. What do I shoot now golf-wise? Well, I'm a 10 handicap. Last week was the first time I played in probably a year because I didn't play since the start of the pandemic. I shot a 93. What was like a horrible 93 Hollis. I'm four putting. I duff some chips, stuff like that. Yeah, but normally I shoot low 80s. My best round ever is a 76 a few times. Brad Pitt, everybody. Brad Pitt in the house. Overetta, Parasite Perry. Yeah. I was actually disappointed with the 93. I mean, even though I hadn't played, I humbly think I'm at the skill level that I should be breaking 90 no matter what. Pound it, Jessica. I played Warzone. I'm not really a fan of Warzone. It's the same thing. It's like rinse, wash, and repeat. I love Blackout. And I hope they do a Blackout too. Jason, you could use any editor to do video stuff I do. I work a lot with Adobe, just so everybody knows. After Effects Pro. But like any video editor, you could do anything I do. I had the one with ski guys. Love that Lego. Still have the electric monorail. What year are we talking about that monorail? I'm gonna say Vanessa. Yeah. Yeah, we got some hard courses in South Florida. Hollis, Grady Grapefruit, Soupy Candace, Dan Opener, A Black Border Takeout Tom, Ridiculous Reese. I don't know. I don't know. When I first saw this card, like on Instagram, like Simcoe always like posting it, I was like, ah, it's pretty cool. But now I'm like, I've seen it too much. It's ridiculous. Betty Spaghetti, Food Fight Felix. A Call of Duty GPK team. DK, you're on the Fortnite. You're on the Fortnite bandwagon, DK. I see you releasing Fortnite. I don't know. I think we're still talking about Legos Hunted. Man, this is the thing with Legos now. We're gonna get off topic here for 1 second. This is my big pet peeve about Lego nowadays. When I was a kid, you could stare at the box and you could try to recreate that Lego set without looking at the instructions. Now they do all sorts of absurd Lego building inside of the product that make no sense half the time. It's ridiculous. And then there's also like a bunch of different like cool colors that you will never ever see in recent sets that they put in the middle. I don't know. I don't know. I'm being nitpicky. Oh, early 90s. Eventually, I'm gonna do like a Lego city. If we ever move and get a new house, I told my wife already, listen, we're going full Sandy. We're gonna have a room dedicated to Lego. Because my mother-in-law, every Christmas, she has like a Christmas town that she dedicates a room to. And I told her one day I'm gonna have that with Lego. Key West. You know, I'm not really a fan of Key West, man. Me personally. I've been there a few times. I don't know. I'm all Miami'd out, but that's just I'm all Miami'd out. I really am. Like being in Georgia recently, I was like, it just reminded me of how much I want to get out of Miami. Caleb, I like the Funko Pops, the GPK Funko Pops. I have that. Oh my God, that con that. Which one just came out? Of the winter con. No, it's like an online con one that came out of somebody that I bought them. I got two of the other ones that Dead Ted, and I got a they're sealed in the box, like inside the packaging box. I didn't open it up yet, but Loot Luke. Okay, I'm doing a horrible job showing cards, everybody. I apologize. I like just reading comments though. You have to use instruction nowadays, absolutely. DK was a god in NW2 and Black Ops. Those are the good old days when there was like a billion people playing. It was fun, noob tubes everywhere. Just play for fun. Now everybody's a tryhard, DK. Jessica seconds the Lego comment. 1994, set 6991. Wax Max, the numero uno, everybody. Great card. Great card. Bony Tony, there you go. Thank you, everybody. I was like, I can't believe. I know it wasn't semicolon, I because semicolon kept popping up in my head. I'm like, no, it's not semicolon. Who is it? Bony Tony. Thank you. Hey, knickknack. Pound it and welcome. How are we doing? How many doubles do you normally get in a 10? Hey, first of all, not your biz. Pound it. Normally, you shouldn't get doubles in a 10. Adam Appetite. We meet again. Speaking of which, I have to edit a video on the blockchain. I have another one in the lab. Doing good. Good to hear. Everybody's saying hello. Let me put you to the side, Adam. We got a thin Mindy. Hey, we haven't pulled an Adam Bomb, the regular, or Blasted Billy. I want to pull them with the black border, though. Another blockchain video. I like the blockchain, everybody. It's a pretty cool concept. What I don't like is that within the last week, my inventory dropped in price halfway. Very volatile. It's very volatile. All right, Black Border Hard Shelly. Followed by Taco Tim. They do that a lot in Food Fight. They'll follow a parallel with the same base set card. Yeah, Avo, I'm redeeming my appetites. When I have an appetite, I don't mess around. I eat. Hunted ordered pre-ordered 5 Atom Bomb Funko Pops at GameStop when they were coming out and got 2 chases. Nice. I did order 2 from Amazon and I got the bases. Which really, I mean, I hate to doubt people or second guess people, but when it comes to stuff like that, how can you not, you know? All right, Cookie Pusher, Ring Poppy, Sweet Ruth, Pinched Pepper. You really want that OS16? Avo, is the OS16 like $800? Like Retro was saying? Well, I did. This is my second Gummy Gunther, I believe. No, I think I pulled the Black Border Gummy Gunther. Buttercream Maxine. All right, that's the last from the 10. Before I forget, guys, let me put that in a one-touch. That autograph card I pulled. I'll show it to everybody else I got here late. Come on. They didn't make these things adult-proof, did they? Here we go. Tongue-tied, welcome. You're late. Avo, are they on eBay for 500 and up? Like the boxes? Or you said that the guy has complete sets? Let us know. I always feel like I'm performing operation when I put these cards in card savers, because the quality of the card's not that good and you don't want to ding it up, even though I really don't send these to PSA or anything like that. Nice little Brent Engstrom, everybody. Did I look at the number? Yeah, I did. Number 52 of 80. IHOC. IHOC into each and every customer's meal. Thank you, Tongue Tied. Oh, who? Listen. Who in the chat buys like these stands for displaying their cards? Because these right here, they suck. They're horrible. I just bump a card and they fall down. I can't stand it. I can't stand it, everybody. Sir Utch, first time I see that name. Pound it. Welcome. How you doing? You're late to school? I'm always late to school. Complete sets will be available soon. I'll announce the release date when I get the notice. I guess GC Laredo is the GPK press secretary. You use them all the time. No, but I saw in somebody's video, Avo, it was kind of wider, like a wider base. And I thought those are the ones I want. I know, Ant-Man. It's ridiculous. Honestly, like I have a stack ready to send to PSA. I might just send them to the other one of the other grading services. I don't care. I just want them I want them encapsulated. You know what I mean? You're welcome. You're such. Sir Utch. Sir Utch. Are you trying to do a wordplay there? What's going on? Okay, not your biz. Let me get to your question. Guys, I have to open this magnet pack. We're going to do it right now. Another silly question, because like I said, I'm an OG from the OS, so I'm just now getting interested again in the newer ones, but does John Pound do any artwork for them now? No, he does not. He does not. It's a shame. He's the GOAT, everybody. John Pound is the GOAT. Real Derpy Gamer says, Tops only pays GPK artists $1.50 per sketch card they do. That is ridiculous. That is absolutely ridiculous, man. So you're basically telling me that one of these sketch cards I pulled was $1.50. That sucks, man. And I could probably sell that, what, on eBay for $50 or something? I mean, I'm not going to do it. Hunted, you're talking about the one touches? Just type in one touch. You could get them on eBay, Amazon. They're great. I like them. I have not yet. I still just lean them on my boxes. You could do that. You could do that, Hollis. But some of these, you know, I thought they were special. I want, how much are they paying for the autographs? Derpy Gamer, do we know? 50 cents? Excusez-moi. Okay, anyways. Oh, guys, I have this in the camera. We got Fat Matt and Leaky Lou. All right, so I have Babbling Brook. And who else did I pull? I forget. I can't see it from here. His artwork is legendary, your biz. Guys, we're gonna open one blaster. How long have I been streaming? 40 minutes. We're gonna hit the hour mark. We're gonna do a blaster. And maybe a value pack. That's why they let the artists do the returns. So at least that's nice of them, Abek. You're welcome, Haunted. Haunted. I keep saying haunted, don't I? Haunted. DK says, I feel any money made selling a sketch part of that should be donated to the artist if that's the case. Yep. I think that's a good thought. Because this is the sacrifice I made, E-Dogs. I made it to hopefully pull more hits. I was in a drought, and I don't like being in a drought. I hope it's not 50 cents either. All right, let me get a blaster. Do I have any readily available? No. One second. I have a red one hanging out. Problem is, like, a lot of these, like, blaster boxes and stuff, I get them and I just put them in a box and store them away. This is adult proof. Speaking of blasters, everybody, these things, they're in Target. They're in Target. The other day I was at Target, right before I left town, and I think I counted 27. Come on. Do I have scissors? Yes, I do. Thank gosh. That's a one-on-one. Yep. Thomas. I'm surprised. If they're getting $1.50 a sketch, I'm surprised some of these artists like don't just like sketch like a Nasty Nick or an Atom Bomb on the return sketch and just put it on eBay. Just make $200 on right off the rip, probably. When the set drops. What's $20 a pop, Avo? Oh, the blasters. Yeah, they're everywhere. Listen, speaking of blasters, I've seen two videos on YouTube where the person pulls the loaded sketch and a hit. I saw a person pull the loaded sketch and an autograph card. And I saw them pull the loaded sketch and another sketch card. It's ridiculous. I was like, I want some of that. Nothing else in here. I don't open these. I just store them. All right, let's go. 10 packs. My body is ready. So, Nick Nacky from Canada. They never have blasters anywhere. Speaking of Canada, Avo, I know you're in here. You know a little bit about GPK. I saw a place selling OS1 wax packs that were made in Canada. Are they different from the other OS1 cards that were made in the US? Because I know like in later sets, like OS3, OS4, they're not. All right, we got a PP yellow funnel Finley. And what OS1 character are they knocking off here? I forget. A Booger Green, Bad Food Brad. Gummy Gunther. Buttercream Maxine. Yeah, Caleb, get some. Although, Caleb, really? I mean, you should get some now just to get them while they're available at the retail stores, because you don't want to pay eBay prices like 6 months from now, because it just basically doubles. It'll go to 40 within a few months once they're not in the stores. Sometimes, look at all this pack dust. Sometimes even when they're still in the stores, people have no shame. They'll just jack up the prices. But I'm having super fun completing my OS4 set right now. And my OS2 set. My OS2 set is a blast. They're both a blast. Completing OS cards, the set's amazing. A Booger Green Takeout Tom, Tex-Mex, Ice Cream Sundae, and Boiled Bonnie. Pounded a Beck. We are having Food Fight GPK Inception. Multiple hits and blaster. Yep, can't beat that, Tongue Tied. I'm jealous. I don't get jealous, but I'm jealous of that. Like, I do not get jealous. I don't see the point of it, to be honest. They're poor quality of Beck, but are they basically the same card? That's what I want to know. Yeah, by Opeachy. Yes, Nick Knack. Okay, Avo's pleading the fifth. Joe Blow. Spicy Spencer. Termite Terry. We have to pull an Atom Bomb, everybody. I can't have a video without pulling Atom Bomb. Hey, Alan, pound it. Welcome. OPG. Was it only called OPG for OS1? And then they just stopped? Hey, Brandon, pound it. How we doing, Brandon? A Booger Green Inflamed Colin. You know what? This name right here, if they ever did semi-Colin, like a C variant, that would be a great name for him. My thoughts. Mr. Houdini, pound it. I saw you in Victor's live stream. Like I said earlier, I didn't want to like take any viewers away from him if that happened, because I really enjoy watching Victor. But when I have a chance to go live, I have to take it. You're welcome, Caleb. $50. Now you could sell that probably 10 times that much. Your biz. Why are these things warped? I'm telling you, the cards I'm finding in blaster tins, the quality is horrendous. A Booger Green Sawyer Sauce. Creamed Phil. Condiment Cody. Yeah, I was watching when his stream crashed in the beginning, Brandon. It ain't easy being live all the time. There's always these like little things that happen. What am I talking about? I don't know. A Booger Green Pounded Parker. Whizzing Winthrop. This was DK Subconscious when he was a little boy in the tub. Same size as US? Okay, thank you, Abeg. Thank you, Jason. Listen. Okay, Blended Billy. We'll take it. I can't find fat packs anywhere. Anywhere, E-Dogs. Okay, I did find them. I do have like 20 something of them, but I want 100 of them. Because I want to get them before the prices really jack up. But I don't get it. There's like tins everywhere now at Target and no fat packs. And normally it's the other way around. At least where I live. Atom Bomb's playing games with us, Hunted. A Booger Green Hard Shelly. Followed by a Pee Pee Yellow Cavity. Gretadine. Battling Bev. Great card. Great card, everybody. Trashy Trey. I don't have any card shops near me, everybody. Yeah. It happens, Brandon. The fat packs is the more value pack, Jason. It's the pack with like 22, 24 cards. It's the one that comes with the purple borders. Unaware Eddie. Dylan Pickles. Let me tell you, they tried to do it to me again at Target. They tried to limit my purchase of GPK. I said, no. Bring the manager. I go, I don't know about you, but these aren't MLB. These are not NBA. These are not NFL cards, like it says in your sign. These are non-sports cards. Plus, I told May, listen, I'm a teacher. I buy them for my class. So then she was like, oh, okay, no problem. I had to spruce it up a little bit. All right, we got an Adam Appetite, everybody. Booger Green, Zesty Zoe. Messy Jesse. Tony Tomato. Potato. Boardwalker. Yeah, they have the cereal cards as well. Honestly, I think maybe there's one I like. Bryce Krispies. The others, eh? That's just me personally, everybody. I thought the 35th anniversary fan favorite cards were awesome. Like the OS1 cards, I thought those were great. I thought 35th anniversary value packs were the best value packs I've seen. My humble opinion. Because everybody loves OS1. And to get a chance to pull like Nasty Nick, Atom Bomb, a Booger Green Balut Luke, Split Brit. Oh my god, the flippers. The flippers are at Target, Brandon. It's nuts, man. Top shifted the price on blasters. Honestly, we have the collector's tin for Food Fight. I don't know why they did what they did with the blaster tins. Putting 10 packs inside a tin. I prefer the $10 blaster with 5 packs. Me personally. Yeah, they are nuts, Jason. But yeah, these guys are just flipping. Like, for example, let's say GPK, we have the blaster tin that's $20, Jason. If they were as popular as sports cards, people would go there, buy the blaster tins from Target or Walmart, go on eBay, and then immediately sell them for like $75. That's what they would do. Because that's what they're doing right now with the sports. I mean, they're trying to make money. I get it. Hey, Booger Green, Mardi Gras. For the people that really like, well, let's just say sports cards, you know, as a fan, and they want to collect sets and stuff like that, and want to try to go for hits, it sucks a lot. And some of these people don't even like sports cards. They just want to make the money. I have yet to open my Midlife Crisis cards from 35th, Avo. Yeah, Sir Utch, listen, I've been to Target, and I've seen Garbage Pail Kid product hidden behind like two other products in the corner. So you have to search the shelf. You even have to lift up the thing to make sure they're not hiding them underneath. All right, this is the last pack of the blaster tin. Can I get a Booger Green Atom Bomb, everybody? No, I can't. Sorry, Charlie. All right, Third Helping Theo, Toast Ted, Shrimpy Cheryl. We're going to finish this off with the value pack, everybody. Okay, everybody read Not Your Business comment. He's asking about MTV non-sports cards. Yeah, it is rad, Brandon. It's a great subset, in my opinion. Listen, I've said it a bunch of times. I'm going to say it again. 35th anniversary is going to age like fine wine. Give it a couple years. Yeah, fat packs are a great deal. You did that once, Brandon? Hey, I don't blame you, man. As long as you're not selling them for like $1,000 afterwards. All right, let me get a fat pack. All right. I got a fat pack. We're gonna complete the trifecta. We can't do the superfecta because I'm not gonna open a hobby box. I just spent ages inventorying all these cards. And now I have to do it again. Why do I do this to myself? Why do I do this? I wanna pull a gold card, everybody. I want to pull a gold card. Let's try to pull a gold card. Okay. Let's assume the position. Starving art. Cue the dramatic music. Although I don't really like messing around with the editing when I stream. Yep, damn them employees. Listen, something's going on. Great card, Wax Max, everybody. Something's going on. Because every time, if you don't, how do I word this correctly? I've been there. I like now, not anymore, but pretty much every day I would go there. The everything's empty except for Magic the Gathering and Fortnite cards. Who wants that stuff? I'm not hating. I'm not judging. Who wants that stuff? But everything's empty except for those two products. And I go every day. And then sometimes I go and I run into the person that restocks the shelves. And there's 30 guys there. Come on, man. What, there's it's like an inside job. It's crazy. And then I've been there sometimes and I see the same group of people. And the guy's not there yet. What's going on? In fact, I don't even like going to Target anymore, to be honest. It's like put a bad taste in my mouth. OS3, OS4, OS5. Okay, man, I was gonna say if you have some OS2 and OS6, let me know. Have yet to open OS1, everybody. It's gonna happen. And listen, everybody, I pull my own cards. I can't buy cards off eBay. I have to pull them myself. I'm just wired that way. All right, a booger green peeping page. Here comes the serial cards. Dig in, Duncan. Oh my gosh, what were these called? My brother used to love these things. Oh my God. This is ridiculous. I forgot. Let me look at the back. Oh. The A and B, that's crazy. Froggy Freddy. It's on the tip of my tongue. It's on the tip of my tongue. It's like toilet paper. It's always on. That's funny. Sugar Smacks or Honey Smacks. I think it's Honey Smacks. Honey Smacks. Ah. Yeah, Steel City's. Listen, that's my recommendation for everybody. Pre-order collector's edition and value, not the value, retail slash hobby boxes from Steel City Collectibles. Because that's where you're going to get the best price. You buy them in bulk. Because I think my hobby boxes came out to like $35 each when I actually went back and looked at it. And I got eight of them. Because sometimes they'll sell the pre-order for the values and the blasters, and it's actually more money than what the retail is. And oh, another Adam Appetite, everybody. Nice. A purple jelly peckish pinky. A booger green Perry premium. Livy Linguine. I'm talking too much, everybody. Shut me up. Shut up, James. Shut up. What are we doing? What are we doing? I'm talking, everybody. That's what I like to do. Honey Smacks. Applejacks, Vanessa? Applejacks are great. My cat's name is Apple. I call her Applejacks. Zesty Zoe. Okay. We hit the hour. Okay, one more minute. We hit the hour. Any questions? Any questions? I got a question. What do I got to do to get a like on my video, on my live stream? What do I got to do? What do I got to do, people? Come on. Come on. Come on. All right, so I'm going to tell you what you have to look forward to. I have a blaster battle with Avo. I have my first video ready. He hasn't let me know when his video is going to be ready. He started on the back end. I started on the front end. We're not in sync, everybody. I am Jason. I have a second sketch card that I pulled. I'm making a video on that one. It's in production right now. My top pulls video is ready to go. Maybe I'll release that tomorrow. I have the blockchain video that I need to finish editing. I have another OS4. I have another OS2. Listen, I have a lot of videos in production. The problem is, thank you, Derpy Gamer. I appreciate that. Sometimes I don't want to stare at a computer screen. I already have to stare at a computer screen all day long for school. So, Baked Brent. It's a good looking piece of artwork, Brandon. How many licks does it take to get to the Tootsie Roll Center by Tootsie Pop? 1, 2, 3. I think it's 3. Thank you for the likes, everybody. Thank you for the likes. It'll be ready next week. Everybody's gonna have to wait. I made a fine first video, in my humble opinion. I took it easy on Avo. I took it easy. Hey, Ryan. Pound it, Ryan. Welcome. Did you hear that Target is only gonna let you buy cards Friday morning? What? Come on, man. Listen, here's the thing with Target. I'm gonna talk about that really quick. I understand you wanna limit a certain product to allow other people access to that product. But here's the but part, everybody. At the end of the day, you're in the business of selling product. If people buy it, it doesn't matter if it's one person or 100 people buying like 100 products, pieces of products, so to speak. It's getting sold. So I'm a little, I don't like them meddling in as much as it is great for other people to get cards. Thank you, Dustin. Dustin, did you pound it? Pound it, man. Thank you, Suresh. I appreciate it. DK, I'm going to tell you something about my local Walmart. There's about 3 Walmarts in my general area. One of them completely stopped stocking cards. They just said, forget about it. They don't do it anymore. Because one day I went, I was like, wait a second. Where did everything go? And I went and I spoke to some employees. They're like, listen, they just stopped bringing it in. Something happened and they said no more. Friday morning is only sports and Pokemon. Okay, that makes sense, Alan. That makes sense. But then again, you're just going to have a long line of people. But hey, what they should do, listen. If you have a product that is just flying off the shelves, stock it every day. Stock it twice a day. Come on, man. Which GPK Funko Pop would you like to see next? That's another thing I do have. Somebody was asking me, I think it was Jason. I do have Funko Pops that I have in the background. I'll pick them up here and there of certain ones I like Back to the Future, Guardians of the Galaxy, what have you. Teddy bear is my second favorite character of all time. Beck says Target stock overnight on Wednesday and then first come first serve Thursday morning. They should do it just every day. If you know it's gonna sell, just do it every day. Maybe one of the US Armies hunted. If I'm going to talk for a few more minutes, I'm going to open up another value pack. I did. That's another video I have to do. I got some stuff in the mail. And the problem is, I just, if somebody's going to send me something in the mail, I want to do it proper. I want to thank them properly. I want to put some thought and time into the video. Another value pack, everybody. Yep, man, your biz. Money's still green. It doesn't matter. Yeah. I'm personally not a fan of Walmart in my area. People, I'm from Miami. It's officially become a third world country. And plus, like, people just roll out of bed and walk into Walmart. I'm pretty sure there's some people that haven't showered. Hey, Haunted, pound it. What's going on? Oh, Jason. Okay, everybody. Jason, let me put it up on the screen again. I'm sorry. These right here, those OS cards are actually cards when I went back to my dad's house before the pandemic started. I had some GPK product. I had OS 7, I had OS 4, I had OS 3. And that OS 7 box I had sitting there for years. I never opened it. I never opened it. And it was that OS 7 box where I was pulling the purple banner variants for Bobby Booger and Blasted Billy the Second. And the white number version of Alexander the Great. But yeah, I grabbed a bunch of my OS 3 cards. And those are actually, you could look them up on Amazon. I want to say BCW, just type in like card frame holders, something to that effect. And those are 9 because the OS3 puzzles are 18 cards. So I just put 2 together and that's how I got those frames. It's actually 2 frames put together for each one. All right, let's go back. Now you know, Sigmund, and knowing is half the battle. Jason, pound it. Jason, hey, I forgot where you commented on. I think it was, you commented something about Tech TV, and I'm going here on YouTube searching in Tech TV to hear you call in on Tech TV. We have a mini celebrity in the house, everybody. Jason, welcome, Jason. Ashcan Andy is a great card. Dead Ted is a great card. Oh, you can't go wrong with OS1, everybody. Okay, we're thinking of a gold card. That's what we're thinking of. A Booger Green Twin Keith. Followed by a Purple Border Tenderized Travis. Trixie Cereal. Unlucky Luke. You're welcome, Jason. G.I. Joe. A Booger Green Still Life Stan. No hit. It is what it is. Flaky Fran. Woo. Well, Skynet alert, everybody. Let's all go to the lobby. You know what? No. Guys and gals, we're going to do 5 value packs. We're going to make this a food fight extravaganza live stream. Why is this card backwards? Makes no sense. Makes no sense, people. All right. 3 more. 7. Pound it. You have a ton of them you never uploaded. Used to love technology. I love technology. Technology is good. But I'm old school as well. Physical interactions the youngins need to learn about, in my opinion. All right, that's about right. A collector's tin, a blaster tin, 5 value packs. We're going to do it. We're going to do it. But yeah, let me tell you, as I was inventorying cards today, I was just like, Tops, come on, man. Please improve the card stock. Got a little Got a little nervous, everybody. Atom bomb, everybody. Atom bomb. All right, we're going quickly. A Booger Green Spicy Spencer. Great Nate. Cuckoo for Cocoa. A little Wacky Jackie. All right, we got some Adam Appetites tonight. What was that, my third one? My fourth one? A Purple Jelly Loaf of Fred. A Booger Green Pop Corey. Herschel Squirts. Nothing to see here, everybody. Nothing to see here. Yes, the Roybot would be nice, Hunted. For the Funko Pops. Let me tell you. I know OS1 is the GOAT set, but OS3 and OS4, they can go pound to pound with any set out there. Yeah, Beck, the cardstock is amazing. Kevin Rose used to answer the phones back then. Now he got serious money and pulled in the industry. Skynet is lurking. I feel it. I feel it too. My Skynet senses are tingling, everybody. As LeBron said in Miami, not one, not two, not three, not four, but five. I don't want to speak ill of anybody. I used to be a big LeBron fan. Not so much anymore. Here's Baked Brent. Seven pulled a gold hot dog, Dave. It is a hit. It is a hit, Seven. That's a great card. Because that's basically New Wave Dave. So that's one of the top dogs of this set. A Booger Green West Quick. Fruity Loop. Okay, this is funny. I think this is the first Fruity Loop I've seen. Or Fruity Lupe. Lupe. I think I said it right. Drew Barry. Another Adam Appetite. Good Shiza. A Purple Border Betty Spaghetti. Oof, that looks like that hurts. A Booger Green Feast in Easton. Let me tell you, OS3 was my first set, so I always say it's my favorite. But oof, I've been looking at the OS4 lately because I'm trying to complete the set. And OS4 artwork is amazing. It is amazing. There's basically no... There's no filler in that set. Because you could kind of see it in a set like this. You got the killer, and then you got the filler. All right, last pack, everybody. And then, good Shiza, Seven. And then I'm going to have to, what are we, an hour and 12 minutes? Skynet free. Then we're going to have to call it quits something. You know what I'm saying. You know what I'm saying. Oh, Chrome Series 4. Oh, I can't wait, man. I'm going to camp out at Target. I'm going to camp out at Target. We're getting some Chrome Series 4 over here. And I'm actually going to bite the bullet and buy the pre-order of blaster boxes and everything. And the value packs. Yeah, I think Jason was the one that asked my favorite card pool ever. This one's up there too. The short print of Penta Brent. It's up there. Jason's talking to Avo in the chat. Can't go wrong with Adam Appetites, although the prices have gone down, Brandon. I had that GPK Nick autograph card I pulled. At one point, it was valued like at 1,000 wax, and it was like $270. Today I look, and it's valued at $68. I was like, come on, man. I should have sold it. I was going to sell those to try to get some OS1 cards. A Booger Green Uh-Oh Rio. A Purple Border Dawson Cookies. Good Shiza! Good Shiza, everybody! Woo! This is why I pulled five value packs. This is why we went with five value packs. A Gold Border Balut Luke, everybody. Probably around November, van pack. There they come. I was like, man, what's the delay on this? Hey, Alan, thank you for stopping by, man. I appreciate it. I'll see you in the next video, live stream, what have you. Thank you, Jason. Thank you. Here we go. Let's see the number. But Luke has grown on me, everybody. Number 15 of 50. Good shiz. I was saying it when we pulled that autograph card earlier. I was like, listen, we're going to get a gold. Oh, man, that was so unexpected. That was so unexpected. Good shiza. Good shiza. I'm not going to burn it, Ryan. Ryan, listen, everybody. Ryan Calvin is in the chat right now. He has a YouTube channel. He pulled an amazing hit. An amazing hit, everybody. I'm not going to ruin it. Go to his channel. Watch the video. He pulled an epic card. Epic card. Thank you, Abek. Thank you. Good. So now that's my second gold card. So now I have 1.5 gold cards, everybody. Good shiza. Good shiza. See, this is why I can't buy things off eBay. That feeling you get when you pull it yourself, it's unbeatable. Yeah, but Avo, today on your video, Coaster Kate, she sent me some stuff too. I haven't opened it yet. And after seeing your video, I was like, man, the quality is amazing. I can't wait to open those. You just opened 11 and no gold. Sorry, Brandon. Sorry. Thank you, though. I appreciate it. Thank you, Mr. Houdini. Guys, Mr. Houdini, I'm going to put him on blast right now. Let's talk about Mr. Houdini really quick, aka Bobby B. He is an official Topps artist. He has one video on his YouTube channel right now. Bobby, we have 30 people watching right now. I want everybody to go sub to his channel. We're going to put some pressure on him to make some live drawings, something to that effect. We need him to upload more. Official Topps artist, everybody. Mr. Houdini, aka Bobby B. Go check him out. Yeah, it is. They looked insane. They looked insane. And the other day, my wife was, we were at the store. She's like, we need, because we've redone the whole first floor. She's like, we need coasters. We need coasters by the couch now. And in my head, I'm like, well, I got some coasters. Not sure if you're going to want them. Thank you, Jason. I appreciate that. All right. Any last questions before we sign off here? Wait up. Do I have another one touch? No. I don't have another one touch. I need to get more one touches. It is what it is. Thank you, Jason. I appreciate that. I'm on team King Kong, everybody. Actually, I think I'm going to go walk my dogs, to be honest. I appreciate that, Tongue Tied. I appreciate that. I will see you in the next video live stream, Tongue Tied. Thank you, Ryan. I appreciate it. Listen. One second. I transferred one of my cards out to put this one in. Here we go, everybody. We got the Balut Luke in a one-touch. Good shiza. So I'm going to tell you something. It kind of worked. The sacrifice kind of worked. I'm going to keep this foot cheese, Charlie. You too, Derpy Gamer. Thanks for stopping by. You're welcome, Mr. Houdini, Bobby. Thank you, Hunted. Thank you, Avo. Thank you, Seven. All right, Sigmund, take care. Gone away. Listen, you have to give me a name. I don't know. Like, I don't want to say I feel weird calling you gone away, but I appreciate it. Thank you, gone away. Stay gold, Pony Boy. Stay gold. Let me put this in a sleeve while I do that. All right. So, guys and gals, thank you for stopping by. Thanks for hanging out with me. I appreciate it. And everybody else who's left. If you come back and watch the remainder of the stream, I appreciate it as well. Duncan, pound it. Pound it. I appreciate that, DK. Get back to the family. Do it now. Duncan has a beautiful family, everybody. All right, I'm out. I'm going to put the outro. I'll see you guys and gals in the next video, live stream, whatever it is. Hey, Ron. Wait up. Before... Gone away. You got me stuck here for a second. Not AA Ron. Not AA Ron. Timothy. Timothy. There's another one that's pretty funny. Oh my God, Key and Peele. You know what episode's great from Key and Peele, everybody? This is what I'm going to sign off with. Look it up. Key and Peele, Clear History. C-L-E-A-R history. Look it up. You will not be disappointed. All right. Pound it. Jason, Jessica, everybody. Avo. Avo will be live Saturday afternoon, Eastern time. Fellow YouTubers, if I ever go live and you happen to be live, I'm not doing it on purpose. I take advantage when I can. Pound it. All right. I'm out, everybody. I'm out.
Good night.
Good night.
I'm a friend of Sierra Connor. I was told that she's here. Could I see her, please?
No, can't see her. She's making a statement.
Where is she?
Look, it may take a while. I want to wait. There's a bench over there.
I'll be back.